Hello, Antioch Church. It's Sunday. It's just after 12 noon. I know you finished a great service this morning, and Pastor Ken Yonke, who's been filling in for me, has brought a great message from God's Word. During this time that I've taken away from my day-to-day responsibilities in the office and week-to-week responsibilities in the pulpit, I took the opportunity to come down to our West End Station platform today and spend the entire time of our Sunday morning service sitting on this platform, talking with people, watching the people, and praying, asking God to give us insights into how best to reap the incredible harvest of souls that He has prepared for us. The very, very best is yet to come for Antioch Church. And God has put us here in the heart of the city with an unparalleled opportunity to touch people. You know, sometimes in God's work, the mistake that some have made is to try to reap, they've tried to ripen the field that they wanted to reap. They've tried to ripen the field that they wanted to reap instead of reaping in the field that God had already ripened. In the Gospel of John chapter 4, the disciples were going with Jesus through Samaria on their way to Galilee. That's where their family and friends lived. And Jesus stopped by a well. There was a very open, receptive person there, this Samaritan woman who in a few moments gave her heart to the Lord and then was used by God to reach an entire city. The disciples were thinking about Galilee, but Jesus knew there was a harvest, not of corn or grain or wheat, but a harvest of souls that the Holy Spirit had sovereignly prepared for His ministry in that place called Samaria. And so He reaped where the Holy Spirit had already ripened. That's what God is calling us to do. And as I've spent this morning praying over this platform and talking with people, passing out invitations to our church, telling them a church is coming, I've had a tremendous response. I even had a gentleman this morning give us an offering. I tell you, The Lord is doing an amazing thing. He's touching the hearts of people and giving us an incredible opportunity to help people come to know Jesus. So I just want to encourage you to participate in our 21 days of prayer and fasting as we start the new year. This opportunity to awaken ourselves spiritually, to hear God in a fresh way. This coming Sunday, December 23rd, the Sunday before Christmas, Teresa and I and the children will be with you in service as we celebrate communion together and sing some carols and worship the Lord, commemorating the birth of our Savior. And before we head out of town to spend some time with our extended family over the Christmas holidays, but I just wanted this morning, while my heart was so full, to take the opportunity to tell you that I thank God for the privilege of serving you. I am so thankful to the Lord for the opportunity to link arms with you in planting a church right here in the heart of our city. The very, very best is yet to come, and I am so excited that you are going to be a part of it. God bless you, and we'll see you this Sunday, December 23rd, for our Christmas carols and communion service.